the things that you look for in a 510K submission, and sometimes I feel like this is lost on sponsors, is the first thing that we're looking for is substantial equivalence. I mean, that is the end-all be-all of 510Ks. And so the data that we're looking at, we're looking for data, say performance data, animal data, whatever you have, that data in comparison with the predicate device that you're presenting. And so the gap that exists between the two, and usually there's a gap because new innovative technology, and that's how it works, the gap getting bridged between the two with performance data or whatever data that you have to substantiate that whatever gap exists doesn't create new questions of safety and effectiveness is really what the focus is for 510Ks. So as far as 510K goes, a lot of times that's an independent review actually by a lead reviewer. Sometimes you would bring in consultants from other parts of the agency that have specialization in a particular device area, or if you need a specialized engineer to look at some of the data. As far as IDEs go, a lot of it is based upon ensuring that the device has met a certain safety standard, and that's of the utmost importance. FDA recognizes that you don't know effectiveness, and that's why you need to do a clinical trial. And so the data, including in vivo data from animal studies, or in vitro data on the benchtop, or whatever data that the sponsors present, needs to demonstrate safety of the device and needs to provide as much evidence as possible that it's safe to put into humans or use on humans. When reviewing an IDE submission, it's also really important to take a look at the clinical trial design. And that's of utmost importance, because recognizing that, especially a pivotal trial, recognizing that a pivotal IDE is eventually going to be the data that we see in order to provide approval for marketing, needs to meet a certain bar. And so we spend a lot of time looking at clinical trial design, the statistics of meeting safety and effectiveness endpoints, and ensuring that the way that the data is getting set up to be gathered will be adequate for us to make a determination of approval or not for PMA, so marketing submission.